60 Seconds with Professor Ruth Arnon.
All beginnings are hard, but I think that for women it is even harder. For a woman scientist, she has to start two careers at the same time, both the scientific work and raising a family. In my case, my daughter was born when I was a PhD student, and my son was born when I was a postdoctoral studies. Working at the cutting edge of science means that I have to compete on the international global scene. At the same time, the children have always been my department. So I had to go back to the lab in order to finish my work when everybody else was already asleep, and I had to get up very early in the morning in order to write. As the children grow up, it becomes easier, and the gap between men and women becomes smaller. But the question is, how do you get to this point?
Seconds with Professor Gail Dinter-Gottlieb.
For me to be a scientist is to be able to ask questions, to take curiosity, and to be able to turn it into something that's useful for people on Earth, for life on Earth. It's a tikkun olam. That's my personal understanding of what to be a scientist is. Well, the Weizmann gave me an opportunity to do my postgraduate work in the U.S. When my son was born, I was thrown out of a postgraduate program. And at the Weizmann Institute, despite the fact that I had a newborn daughter, I was given the opportunity to continue my education.
Seconds with Professor Debbie Fass.
My parents are both physicians, so I grew up with the idea that men and women are equal when it comes to a profession. Of course I want to be the perfect wife and mother as well as an outstanding scientist. The problem? Only 24 hours in a day. Fortunately, the Weizmann Institute is a community, one where family life and science come together. My children visit me in the lab, and when there's no time to prepare dinner, there's always Café Mada. But after everyone else has gone to sleep, I go back to work.
Seconds with Professor Vera Rom-Kedar.
Growing up with an ex-Air Force pilot mother and a scientist father, I understood that, male or female, the sky's the limit. In graduate school at Caltech, female students spoke of gender, but I didn't identify. After I had two children during postdoctoral research and another while on the tenure track, I realized that motherhood is different. Dealing with children, husband, and work is not easy. Yet, it's like a double major in the university. With the doubled workload comes a synergy, a broad set of experiences that helps one grow and gain confidence, enhancing both family life and the scientific endeavor.
Seconds with Professor Daniella Goldfarb.
As a girl, I played tennis mainly with boys. By my postdoc, I was the lone woman in my research group, and when I headed my first departmental meeting, opposite me. A young woman scientist never drinks coffee with her male colleagues. She has to take advantage of every minute she has to work so she can get in time to kindergarten to pick up her children. She might help her husband advance his career, but when a woman scientist needs help, she usually asks her mother. Only recently have I found some time to indulge in a hobby or spend some quiet time with my family.